segment of the show for today. The topic is the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, and the guest is Alana McLaughlin, and she has given us some information relative to the end of the institution of slavery with the passage of the 13th, 14th, and the 15th Amendments to the Constitution of the United States, and she's now dealing with the National Association of Advancement for Colored People in a way that will lead her up to the civil rights movement of the 1960s. Now, let's talk about that civil rights movement of the 1960s, because I think the most important person that you're generally familiar with is Dr. Martin Luther King. Let's talk about him within the context of the movement to deal with the 13th, 14th, and 15th Amendments.
Well, in Martin's childhood, he had one friend who was white, and their father told them that they wouldn't play anymore because they were white and he was black. That really struck a kind of a deep hole in Martin's life, a hole that couldn't be filled, because he dearly was playmates with that friend, but only to be pushed away by a thing called segregation. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't think that was unfair. If my friend was, I have Filipino friends, I have Mexican, Indian, Spanish, I have friends from everywhere, and I would feel that it would be right for me not to be their friend because I'm not the same, I don't originate from where they originate, so I wouldn't think that would be fair, and neither should Martin have to put up with something that cruel.
And so that was part of the information that you know about Dr. King, that he had that impact, had an impact on his whole upbringing in terms of his attitudes about, he gave this great speech called I Have a Dream at one time. What was that all about?
Well, one night Martin had a dream, and he said that the dream said that we would all live in peace and that we would all just love each other and hug each other and we would all be friends. Now, him and his wife, Coretta Scott King, they march and they go around the world talking of this dream, they say. And they say that it was just of peace and everybody loving each other and just everybody being friends and just no hatred in the whole world.
Well, now, does it sound strange to you that a person like Dr. Martin Luther King, who had such a dream, should be killed by somebody? Why don't you say something about his assassination?
Well, one day he was in his Memphis hotel in Boom. There was a gunshot. Nobody knew what was happening, so everybody went up, and then they saw Martin Luther King in a pool of blood on the balcony of his Memphis hotel.
And at the Lorraine Hotel in Memphis, Tennessee. And
that really struck a hole in his wife, Coretta Scott King's life. That really struck a hole in her life. And she, I believe she never got remarried. And I believe that really kind of caused a kind of a hole in her life because she deeply loved Martin. And I'm sure I would be deeply struck if my husband was assassinated because he would stand up for what he believed in.
And so that I Have a Dream speech has had an impact upon you as well as some of your peers. Do you know anybody else who has the same understanding of the I Have a Dream speech of Dr. Martin Luther King?
There may be a lot of people who feel as I feel, but not as many youth as there should be. As you grow up, you can get more of a better understanding of Dr. King and of how he lived his life, and you could get a better understanding. Now, I'm nine, I have a very great understanding, and I could teach anybody about him, but I think more youth should learn about Dr. King, and more adults should also.
And not only, I think one time you came to us on and you dealt with the sesquicentennial of the Civil War, in which you talked about the importance of us. So you would put the Civil War and the Civil Rights Movement together as something that people ought to know about.
And yes.
How would you tie those two events together?
Well, they were both fought with whites and blacks. Now, the Civil Rights Movement, it was saying that the white people were against the black people. In the Civil War, the people, they all wanted to be together, but the white people, they couldn't stand that, so they fought to try to kill as many black people or free men as they could.
And of course, all of that